Otano, for Dikama! Otano, for Dikama! Otano, for Dikama! Otano, for Dikama!
Well met.
Otano, for Dikama! Otano, for Dikama! Obidao, Navora, Sesma! Otano, Dikama!
An age of greetings to you.
Tano for Zigama!
No flux sass.
Obi down. Labora. Sesma.
Yeah. Hello.
Greetings.
Tunnel for Digimon!
Greetings.
your tunnel for Dickama!
Tunnel for Dickama!
Ortano, for Digimon! Ortano, for Digimon! Ortano, for Digimon! Ortano for Digimon! Ortano for Digimon! Ortano for Digimon!
Thank you. be down.
Navora, Sesma! Ortano! Ortano, for Digimon! Ortano, for Digimon! Ortano, for Digimon! Thank you.
I am overburdened. Perhaps you should bear some of my load.
Greetings. Once more, I must thank you for planting the Ultarg seed trees for me. Or is this the first time I'm thanking you? No matter. I am grateful in any case. Greetings. Once more, I must thank...
Thank you. Thank you.
Well met.
Your end draws
nigh. Soleno Salatka.
Ortano Fortigama.
Ortano, Fortigama. Ortano, Fortigama.
Down. Navora, Sesma!
Thank you.
Ortano, for Digama! Ortano, for Digama! Ortano, for Digama! Ortano, for Digama! Ortano!
Ipu Soleno Samatka!
I welcome and greet you.
down. Navora, Sesma!
Done well to find the second word. Its power draws my spell so that my projection may speak to you in this vision. There is much you must know. Morgrim is nothing but a fool. He does not truly understand what he seeks. The words ancient beyond imagination. They contain power he cannot fathom. I, Hadraline of the World Slaves, was there at the beginning when the world was hot and this land was jungle where the old ones ruled. The living power of the words Morgrim seeks had to be bound in the flesh of the word slaves. We were unwilling guardians, our souls tied to the ancient magic of the old ones. When the world was hot, we word slaves suffered for the empire of the old ones. The words, ripping their power from our tortured spirits and our living flesh. The old ones are my people, an ancient race of lizard folk who ruled the north before the dawn of time. We were old when even the elves were young. We were the first. We were the creator race. But we were also a race of unbridled cruelty. The strong ruled, and the weak suffered. And we word slaves suffered most of all. Such was the way when the world was young and hot. Once this winter land was a lush jungle. Vents from the earth blasted scorching steam into the sky, and the world was warm and fruitful. The old ones lived in this paradise, as did we word slaves. The world grew cold, the jungles died, frost and snow covered the land. For all their power, the masters could not stop the change. They vanished from the world, consumed by the earth that had turned against them. When the old ones vanished, the power of their words remained, as did we, the word slaves, bound to that power, forced to walk the now frozen and desolate earth, forced to preserve the words and legacy of our masters. Many word slaves died when the endless winter came, but some learned to survive in the frozen waste, hiding from the lesser races who now hunted us. To survive what the masters could not endure. Over the centuries, the magic of the words became dormant. Their power faded. And as we who were left behind grew strong, the bonds enslaving us were broken. We who had once been slaves scattered and hid the words so that we would be forever free of their legacy. Now, thousands of years have passed, and even we who hid the words no longer know where to find them. Morgrim seeks to unlock the dormant power of the words so that he may enslave again. Word slaves, humans, dwarves, elves. Morgrim would have all bow to him as master. Spare me your sarcasm. You are as big a fool as Morgrim. Morgrim is already doomed. The words were meant to release ancient evil upon the land. To devastate those who survived the change, the old ones could not. The plague was only the first of the evils the words will unleash. The world as you know it shall be no more if Morgrim succeeds. This is the legacy of the creators. The words of No! It cannot be! Morag! Morag! He strikes at me! This cannot be! She attacks me through the words. She disrupts my spell of projection. No!
The city of Neverwinter is forever in your debt for recovering the first word of power. We hope you will have continued success on your mission to thwart Margrim and his followers. But now is not the time to dwell on past successes. There are more words yet to be found before Margrim gets his claws on them. Why didn't you say something earlier? Hopefully this will slow the armies advancing on Neverwinter. At the very least, the loss of another word of power will strike a harsh blow to the plans of Mulgrim's cult, whatever they may be. You have done well. The Lord's Alliance and Neverwinter are grateful for your efforts. And on their behalf, I would like to give you this reward of 3,000 gold coins. I wish I had something to spare, but the few magical items donated by the retired heroes of the Lord's Alliance are required in the defense of Neverwinter. I have nothing to spare. I'm sorry. Adraline, what did the Lizard Woman have to say this time? I'm no history expert, but wouldn't that make her thousands of years old? I'm not sure whether I believe her, and I don't know what this has to do with Margrim. But I intend to try and find out. Leave Hadraline to me. Margrim and his crew are still skulking around the countryside, which means they must believe there's at least one more word still undiscovered. Find it before they do. I wish you luck in your mission. The very survival of Neverwinter may depend on it.
You. Your name is well known among us. Oh, it was you who stood forth to defend Rolgen and his trial. You bring honor to yourself and your ancestors.
Taste the open air once more. Freedom is sweet upon my tongue. I say, Utgard, with the verdict that cleansed the word murderer from my name. And I thank you. You are a true friend of the Utgard people. The Red Tiger Tribe speaks your name with reverence.
Yes, what?
Welcome, my child. Do you bring me news of the Utgard Elk Tribe? Or is there some other purpose to your visit?
Thank you.
Welcome again. Welcome again.
Tetra Blast!
Otano for Digimon! Ortano, for Dikamon! Ortano, for Dikamon! Ortano, for Ortano, for Dikamon!
Hello to you.
I am overburdened. Perhaps you should bear some of my...
Thank you.
things.
I greet you, my chum.
Thank you.
Ortano, for Dikamon!
Ortano, for Digyamar! Ortano, for Digyamar!
Digimon!
Vatka! Slero! Samatka! Portano! Portigama!
Portano, Portigama! Portano, Portigama!
Portano for Diyamar!
So, at last you have come. I assume my fire giant servants are dead. No matter. They are of little consequence to me. I can find other servants. Perhaps even you will serve. Come closer. I will not harm you. These last days of the eons of my life pass slowly now, and I would speak with you to break the monotony. Of a dead dragon. Now you will die. essence of a dead dragon. Now you will die. Betrayal. The tainted essence of a dead dragon.
Otano, for Dio!
Betrayal.
Samatka! Tiku, Soleno, Samatka!
I am overburdened. Perhaps you should bear some of my load. Overburdened. Perhaps you should bear some of my load.
Word is yours, but time is short and Morag stirs. The city you call Neverwinter is under siege. Soon it will fall to Morgrim, and he will possess the Source Stone. Morag was the queen of my people, the Old Ones, the Creator race. It was she who created the Source Stone. When the world became cold and the snow covered the land, Morag used the words to put her people into a deep hibernation when the cold winter came, imprisoning the heat of the steam fissures in the magical Source Stone, and her and all her people with it. The old ones could not survive the coming of the winter storm. Morag sought a shelter where she could escape the death of ice and cold. Within the Sawstone, Morag would gather her strength year after year, century after century. When her power waxed full, we word slaves would awaken the queen to banish the never-ending winter. Something has awakened Morag's spirit. Though her body and true power remain trapped in the Sawstone for now, she speaks to Morgrim through projections, as I am speaking to you. Morgrim serves her, a pawn, blinded by her promises of rewards and power. The plague was the first step in Morag's return. Each death fed the queen's power, bringing her closer to a true awakening. Now, Morgrim seeks to claim the words of power the Lord's Alliance has hidden in Castle Never to complete the awakening. If he succeeds, Morag will bring complete and utter devastation to the North. You must return to Neverwinter before the city falls. Speak to the one you call Eren Gend. I will try to meet you there.
See the proof of his death with my own eyes.
Thank you.
I have just received the latest reports from the battlefield, and things are grim. The walls of Neverwinter have been breached, and the Lord's Alliance has retreated to Castle Never under the onslaught. Aerith, with her intimate knowledge of our strategies, crushes our forces in every encounter. Half the city is under the control of her Luskan forces. And what of your mission? Have you found the success our troops have not? Finally, some good news. And not a moment too soon. Even now, I am preparing to leave for Castle Neverwinter to help ensure the words I sent there for safekeeping are not captured by Erebeth. I might as well open my coffers to you before we go. The money was meant to fund the defense of the city, and you seem to have done more for that cause than anyone else. Better I give the funds to you than let the Luskan forces loot them. You have done well. Take this reward of 4,500 gold coins. You have earned it. And there is more where that came from. If you accompany me to Neverwinter to aid in defending the city, the Lord's Alliance desperately needs someone such as you. I wish I had something to give you, but all such items have been sent to the battlefronts to aid in the war effort. Time grows short. We must return to Castle Never to defend its walls and the words of power within from Erebeth and Malcolm. We will leave right now if you are ready. I only hope we are not too late.
The words of power, the tools of a creator race. Hadraline spoke of them as though they could shape worlds, and perhaps they had. With these in hand, victory would not be far behind, or so it was thought. While Eren Gend searched for the ancient relics, Morgrim's army pressed their attacks against Neverwinter. Their dark magics and sheer numbers soon overwhelmed the defenders. The betrayer, Erebeth, was at the forefront when the walls were breached. The words of power, once thought safe within Castle Never, were in danger of falling to the enemy. And behind the invasion, an even greater evil, Morag, Queen of the Old Ones, had awoken.
We meet again. As you know, I am Nasha Alagonda, Lord of Neverwinter. I was once an adventurer like you, though that was long ago. Eren Gend tells me you have done much in the defense of our city. For this I thank you, though I fear it was all in vain. Erebeth knows our defenses too well. We could not stand against her forces. The enemy has breached our walls. All is lost.
Do not give up hope, my lord. We still have the words of power, after all.
And what good has that done, Eren? We have no way to use them. Whatever magic is locked within those stone tablets is of no use to us.
Perhaps Hadraline will reveal their secret to us, if you release her from the dungeons.
I don't trust that creature, Eren, and neither should you. We have done her no harm. If she was truly our ally, she would tell us what she knows.
Hadraline told us about the secret door beneath Castle Never. Without her, we would never have found the Source Stone.
And what good has that done, Eren? That creature won't tell us anything about it. The Source Stone is as useless to us as the words of power.
Perhaps Hadraline will speak to our champion. She has spoken with them before.
Enough, Eren. Now, if you want to speak to Hadraline, you are free to do so. But I will not release her from the dungeon while an enemy is within our city gates. Personally, I think this is all a waste of time. Words of power, the Source Stone, Hadraline. What good is this against Erebeth's army? Our fate is sealed. We are all doomed. After all you have done for the city, the least I can do is answer your questions, although Gend probably knows more than I do. Once, I was an adventurer like you. Were the situation not so desperate, I would call upon the court bards to sing you tales of my exploits. But I am long since retired. I am ruler of Neverwinter now, and my life is one of administrative duties and the delegation of responsibility. Hardly the stirring stuff of legends. I miss those days of glory and heroism, but I gave them up to serve the city I love. Alas, my sacrifice was all in vain. Neverwinter will fall, and I can do nothing about it. Gend can probably answer your questions better than I, but I'll help you if I can. The reports are grim. In the initial assault, Luskan overwhelmed us with sheer numbers and the unbridled ferocity of their attack. Erebeth knew our defenses too well. We never stood a chance. My troops are loyal, but against such odds, there's little hope. It's only a matter of time until Castle Never itself falls. Reinforcements from the Lord's Alliance are marching, but they are too far away. By the time they arrive, all that will remain of Neverwinter is burnt bodies and charred rubble. It is too late for that, I fear. Our defenses are already broken. The damage has been done. If Erebeth and Morgan were both slain, there is a chance it might break the spirits of the Luskan invaders. But I wouldn't count on it. The Luskans attacked with a rage and ferocity I have never seen before. Some sinister force drives our enemies forward. Or perhaps this is justice of a sort. Neverwinter may have brought this doom upon itself. The blood of Fenthic is on my hands. After the plague, the mob cried for blood, and I gave it to them. Fenthic was guilty only of trusting Desta. He was no enemy of Neverwinter. And yet I saw him hanged for failing to protect the city, as was his sworn duty. Can we really be so surprised Erebeth betrayed us after we executed her lover? That is what I tell myself over and over, but the words are hollow to my own ears. I only wanted to do what was best for Neverwinter, to heal the wounds left by the wailing death. Yet even as I passed sentence on Fenthic, I knew in my heart it was wrong. This was not justice. Fenthic died to feed the city's lust for revenge. And now Neverwinter shall fall to an army that was raised to feed Erebeth's own vengeance. Perhaps that is justice. I fear it is too late for that. Fenthic is dead and Erebeth... Perhaps if I were given the chance to pass judgment again, I would act differently, more mercifully. But I fear that chance shall never come. I must live with the burden of what I have done, as must my city. Neverwinter will fall. Gend can probably answer your questions better than I, but I'll help you if I can. We captured the lizard woman slinking around the city shortly after Luskan attacked. After Erebeth's betrayal, I'm not too trusting, so we are keeping her locked in a cell in a dungeon. She was hissing and babbling about Mogrim, wanting the words of power and the Source Stone. But we couldn't get much else out of her. She's half mad, I fear, and doesn't seem to trust us. Gend seems to think she might trust you, though. You're free to speak with her in the dungeons if you wish. Gend can probably answer your questions, but I've given them to Master Ford, Chief Archaeologist of Neverwinter. He seems to think there's some link between the words and the Source Stone. Initially, I hoped he could figure out how to unleash their power. But even as wise as Master Ford is, he hasn't been able to learn anything more about the Words of Power or the Source Stone. Since we discovered the Source Stone in the secret chambers beneath Castle Never, Master Ford has spent all his time studying it. You can go speak to him to see what he's discovered if you wish, though you might have more luck getting information from that creature Hadraline if you can get her to talk. Of course, but before you go, maybe Gend is right. Maybe you should go speak to this Hadraline creature. I doubt it will do much good, but maybe, just maybe, she knows something that can save us. We're desperate, after all. Any important information you come across should be reported directly to Eren Gend. I've placed him in charge of the defense of the city.
These are indeed dark times. though not so dark as Lord Nashor portrays them. The people of Neverwinter are made of sterner stuff than any of us imagine. But if Neverwinter is to survive, we must all play our part. My place is here by Lord Nashor's side. I must oversee every aspect of the defense of the city. And your own part is one you know all too well. You must save Neverwinter once more, though how you might accomplish this I cannot say. Perhaps the creature Hadraline knows something of this. I once knew every secret in this city, but these are turbulent times, and even I am left stumbling in the dark. Yet, I will tell you whatever I can. He was once a great adventurer, you know. I wish you could have known him then. A true hero in all his magnificent glory. He is a different man now. Still a good man, but the bureaucracy and responsibility of leadership weigh heavily on him. He has grown somber and serious. And now, in Neverwinter's darkest hour, I fear he has given in to complete despair. Erebeth's betrayal, the guilt over Fenthic's execution, the slaughter of his people. Sometimes the burden on Lord Nashor is too great. Heavy is the head that wears the crown, they say. There is little we can do for him, other than trying to save the city. Is there anything else? I'll do my best to help you. Things have calmed since the initial onslaught. The defenders fell back to the city core. But I do not know how long we will be able to hold it. We are badly outnumbered, and Erebeth knew every inch of this city. All her knowledge is being used against us now. I doubt it would help. Erebeth has likely shared our every weakness with all her generals by now. If Mogrim were killed, it might break the enemy's spirit. Though in truth, that also seems unlikely. Normally, Luskan forces are but cowards and raiders. They hit and run. This time, however, something is different. Some sinister force drives our enemies forward. And there is a pall lingering in the air. A dark cloud hanging over all the defenders and driving them to despair. Surely you must feel it. There is a shadow over Neverwinter. A curse that drags down morale and inspires our enemy. Perhaps on some level. The people of Neverwinter feel they deserve to suffer. I know Lord Nashor feels such guilt, at least, for what happened to Fenthic. It's one thing to say the law is always right, but there are exceptions to every rule. Fenthic's execution was legal, but even while he was pronouncing sentence, I suspect Lord Nashor knew justice was not being served. Fenthic's death was born of anger and vengeance. Plain and simple. The same motives behind Erebeth's betrayal. Lord Nashor is well aware we reap what we sow. For all our sakes, I hope he is given that chance. Is there something else I might do for you? I'll do my best to help you. Hadraline told us about the Source Stone and secret door beneath Castle Never. As spymaster, I'm embarrassed to admit, I never suspected there were hidden chambers beneath our dungeons before this. When we found the stone, Lord Nashor put Master Ford, Neverwinter's leading archaeological expert, in charge of studying it. But so far, the Source Stone has refused to give up its secrets. If you want to know more about it, you should speak with Master Ford. I'll do my best to help you. Lord Nashor gave them to Master Ford, chief archaeologist of Neverwinter. He believes there is a link between the words and the Source Stone. But Master Ford has not been able to learn anything more. I'll do my best to help you. She arrived here shortly after the third word of power was delivered to Castle Never. Lord Nashor suspected she was a spy and had her imprisoned in the dungeons. After Erebeth's betrayal, he has grown overly cautious, and I fear it has made Hadraline mistrustful of us. She did tell us about the Source Stone beneath the castle, but nothing beyond that. Maybe you could try speaking to her. She trusts you. And I sense there's something important she's not telling us about the words of power and that Source Stone. You should speak to Hadraline before you go. Maybe she will tell you something about the Source Stone or the words of power. My instincts tell me
that she is the key if Neverwinter is to be saved. And I have learned to trust my instincts.